to invite Professor Dr. Sarayug Yadav. I'm sure he's going to share the beautiful thoughts that we have all witnessed today. Over to you, Professor Dr. Sarayug Yadav.
Thank you very much, Braj, for your beautiful introduction. I am really delighted to be a part of this great event in which I got opportunity to listen Dr. Rasmi Jeta, Mr. Bisjit Chaube, and an eminent psychologist, Namrata Gupta. Besides a galaxy of young students full of energy and vitality who really represent Pine India. Because the main objective of this program was to just awaken the youth. And we know that youth are the most important and dynamic segment of our population. We know that unless and until our youth are empowered, our country cannot be empowered. So I listen all of the panelists with and critically. I am sir extremely relevant. I would not just repeat them, but I would like to just remind all of the young students who are the participants here, particularly because this program is mainly meant for them, that actually, you know, when we talk youth, actually youth must understand that, you know, some questions were also very eye-opening by them. They also shared their experiences. It was very enriching and illuminating for all of us. And particularly your insight, which you provided for the participants as a mentor of giant state. It is plausible, it is audible, it is actually very, you know, praiseworthy effort. What I mean, actually, you know, this kind of effort should be continued. What we lack in our society is that we do no doubt talk about youth, but we don't give proper representation of the youth. So I congratulate you that you have provided them ample space to interact, to share their views. No doubt our panelists enlightened them, but it was also necessary to know their views. What are there in their minds? Because, you know, youth must represent in every sphere of life in the country. No doubt, you know, we have already passed 75 years of independence, but rightly some of our students have pointed out that still our country is facing a variety of inequalities, variety of discriminations, and corruption, gender discrimination, and you know, everybody knows this. What is the reason? The reason is that, no doubt, our country is, you know, ruled by our politicians who are the leaders, who are selected and, you know, elected by us, no doubt. But what I feel that now time has come when youth must be motivated to participate in politics. Because unless and until, because who will be the policy maker? Unless and until youth represent in the parliament, in the assembly hall, assembly, state assembly, I believe that somehow or the other, their interests are not served in a true sense of the term. And I believe that youth have the potential and youth should never compare themselves to others. You are not comparable to others, you are unique. You have tremendous potential and vitality, energy, which you can use as an agent of change in the society. As rightly pointed out by, you know, Abhijit Chaube, that you must be a critical readers. Reading is essential. No doubt I do agree with Rasmi Jeta, who pointed out that film has an age over reading. a book, I believe, because it is a visual art. So visual art is called the fifth Veda. It can be applicable for everyone, whether literate or illiterate. But I still believe that reading, you know, when you read something, it can seriously damage your ignorance. You must be feel enlightened when you are a regular reader. So when you read a book, you talk with a great mind, and it will broaden your horizon of thinking. It will make you a great and creative thinker, and you can analyze the situation in a better perspective. So the problem of the country must be taken holistically, and our youth must come forward to take the challenges. They must come out of comfort box, because we know that the situation of all the youth is not the same. And some are privileged, some are underprivileged, some have a lot of scarcity, but still they must be united and try to being a human being, try to be an Indian, develop a sense of patriotism for the nation. Because unless and until you are empowered, and I also believe that society should also come forward, our politicians should come forward to empower our youth. Because unless and until we empower our youth, our nation can't be empowered. So with these words, once again, I congratulate the mentor of the giant step for this beautiful program. And I